hold block, and press forward, duck, back, up, and forward, because we're exploring the cute and cuddly world of Hello, Internet. Welcome to Game Theory. You know the drill. In three episodes, we've looked at three older games, and last week did get a little touchy-feely, so let's get current and let's get gory. To celebrate the recent release of MK9, we're looking at some of the many painful ways to die in the Mortal Kombat universe. First, let's start with a classic, the human hand heart extraction. Kano's move from the original Mortal Kombat isn't just a memorable gaming scene, it's a staple movie moment, most famously from the Temple of Doom. And yes, to answer the question before it's even asked, ripping out still beating hearts does have its place in history with the Aztecs, the people of the sun. Between the 14th and 16th centuries, before the Spaniards arrived in Mexico, the Aztecs were a thriving culture with a rich religious life in Mesoamerica. They believed, as told in their Legend of the Five Suns, that all the gods had sacrificed themselves so that man could live. To them, a continual sacrifice sustained the universe, with the most common form being the extraction of the heart, which they believed to possess a fragment of the sun's heat. By extracting the heart, this fragment was freed and returned to the sun. One of the two principal deities of the Aztec religion was Huitzilopochtli, the god of the sun at its zenith, and also the god of war. With a flint knife, one incision was made, and then the heart was ripped out, still beating and held up to the sky in Huitzilopochtli's honor. But wait, there's more! Though cremation normally followed, sometimes the body would be used in a ritualistic act of cannibalism. Not even Mortal Kombat took it there, but then again, that was almost 20 years ago, and we've come a long way since then. Speaking of removing organs, let's talk about a human's largest one, the skin. In the newest, 9th installment of the series, Shiva has a nifty little fatality where she rips the skin clean off her opponent's body in two pieces. However, in this case, truth is stranger than fiction. Not only is peeling the skin away from muscle possible, but the Aztecs, yes, them again, could do Shiva one better by pulling it off in one clean sheet. After their careful extraction of the heart, some sacrificial victims would also have their flesh ripped off as a sacrifice to the god Jipetotec, who was said to have given his own flesh so that humanity could have food. Statues depicting Jipe look like a brainstorming session for Silence of the Lambs, complete with a fleshy mask and pair of arms hanging at his side. To honor him, Aztec priests would wear the freshly cut skin garments for 20 days beginning on the spring equinox. Removing it at the end of this period symbolized a renewal of the seasons, much like a snake losing its skin. Now, Shiva may not wear much, but even she didn't go this far. While we're chatting about the women of MK, let's talk about kissing. Kissing?
To the death!
Both Sonya Blade and Kitana have fatalities brought on by a kiss, but aside from a cold sore, mono, or an angry girlfriend, what harm can kissing do in real life? It's not like there's really such a thing as a kiss of death, is there?
Wrong.
The kiss of death actually refers to the bite of the reduvid bug, or kissing bug, of Mexico and South America, which sucks blood out of a human's lips when he's asleep. After feeding, the bug poops, pardon my language, leaving behind fecal matter contaminated with the parasite Trypanosoma cruzi, which causes Chagas disease, a disease affecting all vital organs that is linked to some 50,000 deaths a year. Some symptoms? Swelling and vomiting. Explosions producing three or more rib cages are rare. The Kiss of Death was also a nickname for a small pistol hidden inside a lipstick tube used by the KGB during the Cold War, but none of these things are like the kisses in the game. Is there anything closer? Well, maybe. In my research, everyone kept repeating this exact line. Quote, "By the Renaissance, people were selling poison rings, knives, letters, and even poison lipstick. But nowhere was I able to find any hard evidence supporting this. Instead, it seems that they were confusing a purposeful use of poisonous ingredients in lipstick with an accidental use of ingredients that were found to be poisonous years later, like the ancient Egyptians using fucus algin, a reddish-purple mercuric plant dye. And even today, many bright red lipsticks contain trace amounts of the poisonous element lead. So, what's the verdict on kisses of death?" I say, go forth and kiss as you please. Speaking of swapping spit, what type of reptile is reptile? Are there any human-sized acid-spitting lizards that we should be careful of? Well, there are thought to be only two poisonous lizards, the Gila monster and the Mexican bearded lizard, but both inject their toxins through biting, not spitting, so that rules them out. But that's not the end of the story. Komodo dragons, the largest living species of lizard, have a buildup of septic bacteria in their mouths because of their diet of dead animals. So even though they don't spit to burn off people's faces, they could if they wanted to. Add to that the fact that they can grow up to 9.8 feet long and are known to stand on their hind legs in battles over females during the mating season, and you have a pretty good candidate for the reptile behind the mask. Let's
finish this
by looking at one of the two guys that made this series famous, Sub-Zero. When it comes to gameplay, freezing people and shattering their bodies into a thousand pieces is his modus operandi. But could a Sub-Zero ninja really do this in real life? The answer is a resounding
yes.
Since our bodies are 50 to 65% water, dropping our core temperature enough would practically make us into human popsicles. So let's
turn down the heat
and see what happens. At 86 degrees Fahrenheit, your body enters a state called metabolic icebox. You'll look dead, and you won't move, but you'll still be alive. That is, until 68 degrees, when your heart finally stops. But to be cold enough to actually break off a body part, you would have to get the body down to 28 degrees Fahrenheit, literally freezing your balls off. Considering that liquid nitrogen is around negative 321 degrees Fahrenheit, this doesn't seem so implausible after all. In fact, Sub-Zero isn't the only one making a living off of shattering human ice sculptures. Promessa Organic, a company in Sweden, specializes in eco-friendly burials, where a body is frozen, submerged in liquid nitrogen, then reduced to a powder using sound waves. And that's anything but toasty. And now it's time for my final thought. I'll keep it brief. We've seen a lot of horrendous ways to die today, so what's the take-home message? What have we really learned? Only this. Stay away from Aztecs, because they're crazy. That's really all I got. But hey, it's just a theory. A game theory. Thanks for watching. I'll make a shoehorn.